countries participating in the COP28 summit in Dubai are urged to resolve differences to reach a deal on mitigating climate change. That appeal made by the president of the summit, Sultan Al-Jaber, on Friday. There's only a few days left before the United Nations conference concludes on December 12. But nations have yet to agree on handling the thorny issue of fossil fuels, despite dozens already demanding a deal for an end to their use. Al-Jaber calls on countries to step out of their comfort zones and get the job done.
I need you to step up, and I kindly ask you all to be flexible and to truly and genuinely engage in our deliberations and discussions. Let this COP be remembered as the collective COP, a COP that changed the game, a COP that did transform how COPs are conducted. Let's please get this job done.
The Philippine Tourism Department says long weekends in 2023 have spurred domestic tourism. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco told Teleradio Serbisyo the government is expecting the number of domestic trips this year to exceed last year's 102 million trips. She adds the Philippines is expected to surpass its target of 4.8 million foreign visitors this year.
Nakakatulong din talaga siya, especially sa ating mga local resorts, restaurants, tourist transport and the like. And nakikita po natin na nagiging lively po yung ekonomiya, local tourism economy of our destinations because the more opportunities that there are for Filipinos and their families to travel, the more bookings po yung nakuha ng ating mga local destinations.
The National Bureau of Investigation summons the batchmates of a Coast Guard apprentice seaman who drowned during training exercises last month. Our correspondent Nico Bawa now on the line with that story. Nico?
Ron, the National Bureau of Investigation Death Investigation Division has subpoenaed the batchmates of Mori Caguay, the Philippine Coast Guard apprentice seaman who drowned in the water search and rescue training in Cavite last November 16. Four of Caguay's fellow trainees were summoned by the NBI to give a statement about his death. They were in the same wave as Caguay when he drowned during the training, and they were accompanied by lawyers by the PCG. The PCG personnel declined to give a statement to the media. According to sources, the trainees explained to the NBI agents that they were also struggling to finish the training exercises and did not notice that Caguay was already drowning. The NBI also summoned the other trainees seen in the cell phone video of the incident. According to their statement, they were waiting for their turn to undergo the training exercise when Caguay drowned. Their training continued after Caguay was brought to the hospital. The NBI has already subpoenaed the medical records of Caguay, and they are also set to summon the instructor and medical team of the Philippine Coast Guard. Ron?
Nico Bao with that story. Thank you very much, Nico. The Philippine Coast Guard clarifies the alleged elision between a Chinese vessel and a Filipino fishing boat has nothing to do with Manila's ongoing territorial dispute or maritime dispute with China in the West Philippine Sea. Coast Guard spokesperson Rear Admiral Armand Balilo says the incident is an ordinary maritime incident. The PCGG has since contacted China's Maritime Safety Administration as well as the port state control of Indonesia. On December 5, the Chinese-flagged MV Tai Hong allegedly rammed into a Filipino fishing boat tied to a fish aggregating device. The Chinese crew sailed on, leaving five Filipino fisher folk adrift in the sea.
Itong dinaanan ng nasabing barko ay isang ruta talaga ng mga barkong bumabiyahe magmula sa taas pababa po ng Indonesia. At wala po itong kinalaman sa usapin sa West Philippine Sea kahit na po ito ay flag state ng China. Ito po ay isang ordinary maritime incident at ititreat po natin ito as such.
Other news, around 40 volunteers from fisherfolk and youth groups set off for a historic civilian-led mission to the West Philippine Sea. The group Atin Ito organized a civilian Christmas convoy to bring holiday cheer to troops and local fishermen. The expedition aims to assert Manila's sovereign rights in the West Philippine Sea. Volunteers will be bringing supplies to fishermen and frontliners stationed in Philippine-occupied features like the Patag and Lawak Islands. The convoy is also expected to pass by the general vicinity of Ayungin Shoal. The mission will last until December 13. The Philippine government extends aid to the victims and families of the bombing in Marawi City. Bangsamoro Chief Minister Ahod Ibrahim and Presidential Advisor for the Peace Process Carlito Galvez Jr. visited the victims in various hospitals. The Bangsamoro government distributed cash aid for the victims under its Critical Assistance Program for Indigents. The families of two victims who died were also given 50,000 pesos each. Galvez and Ibrahim assured the victims and their families they will continue to provide aid for their medical and basic needs. Taipei accuses Beijing of deploying fighter jets and a suspected weather balloon across the Taiwan Strait. The Taiwanese Defense Ministry said Friday the balloon was detected along the northern city of Keelung. Officials in Taipei suspect the move is part of China's efforts to interfere with their upcoming elections. The self-ruled island is on alert for Chinese military and political activities ahead of its January 13 polls.